Hello, my name is Veronica Facio. I am an Arts for Learning Miami teaching artist. You can call me Miss Veronica. I am a visual artist, interdisciplinary, meaning that I do many disciplines, like sculpture, photography, performance, and sometimes I mix all of them together. We are going to be making a natural and ephemeral mandala. Natural because the materials will be things from nature. Mandala because we will be following concentric circles. Ephemeral because it's not going to last for so long unless you take pictures, which is what we call documentation. We will be talk about all that later. You will learn what ephemeral, what is documenting a piece. And also you will learn concentric circles and repetition as one of the most important elements of art. What we call found objects in art, we will also talk about texture and shape. The materials we will be using are materials, like I said before, we call them found objects. This time, what we are going to be looking for is in the nature, in the parks, around your house, around your apartment building. Here in Miami, we have a lot of gardens and places where pick up leaves, stones, flowers, sand, maybe already pick up some shells at the beach. If you have nothing that, like that and you don't feel going out to walk, you can go to your kitchen and get beans, different colors, black beans, white beans, rice, lentils, walnuts, anything that is natural. Remember, this is a natural mandala. You also will need some paper where to make the mandala. We will not be gluing anything, so you can, if you don't have a paper in your house, you can use a piece of wood, a piece of something that is nice and even and also in solid color. Okay, see you in a few seconds. Hello, so here we are. Those are the materials that I collected. Actually, my son helped me to collect them. Dante, thank you, Dante, that is here
You're welcome.
also helping me to do this video.
You're welcome.
So we collect one flower. I don't like to cut flowers, even though my garden is full of flowers. I feel guilty when I cut flowers, so I couldn't cut more than that. Those are some of the little, what is the name? Okay, these little branches are always on the gardens. Some gardens put stones, but when you go to the park, you find many different things. Like I said, if you don't feel to go to the park, you can always use kitchen natural material. I also have leaves, and it's important that you pick different colors. Like I have dark green here. I have gray, purple. This is other kind of purple because it's drying actually. Those are big. Maybe I use one in the center. But play with colors. You want colors, you want contrast, you want texture. You see how these leaves have a lot of texture, have a lot of lines. This one is more smooth to the eyes. It's also smooth to the touch. So I'm going to move them a little bit away to have a space in my paper. Like I said, the support paper, the background is going to be, in my case, blue, because I want to have good contrast for you to be able to see the project. But you don't have to use blue. You can use white. You can also do it on the table. Like if I do on the table, you see, it's going to look good too. One thing that I want you to do is to take a picture to document the work. When artists work with this idea of ephemeral, they always document what they are doing. Ephemeral work is always documented by video or photographs. There is an artist that I like a lot. His name is Andy Goldsworthy. He does ephemeral. He lives in England. And there are a lot of videos about his work. If you like ephemeral work, you should Google him and see what he does. He walks around and he makes pieces with the natural material he found when he walks around, next to the river, on the landscape, and he leaves them there. He takes pictures and he leaves the material there. He respects nature very much, and it's something that we need today's days. Mandalas are made usually by Buddhist artists from India. And they also make it ephemeral because they believe that nothing in life stays forever. So that's why they like to make ephemeral pieces, which means that it's going to be away very fast. Unless you document it. If you document it, you have the documentation, either the picture or the video of your art piece. So in the center, I thought first I was going to put one of these, but now since I got one flower, I will use the flower for the center. But you can use a stone, you can use anything you want. And concentric circles are circles that is one little circle and one circle outside and another circle and it grows. That is concentric circles. Each circle is independent of the other one, but it's inside of the next one. It's different than a spiral. A spiral grows. Concentric circles is one inside another. So we will be working with the idea of concentric circles. So my center will be the flower, and I will start to build my first concentric circle by repeating, I will use repetition, these little pieces of wood surrounding the flower. Now next, I want to put some leaves. I will use the green leaves. And this is how I am building my mandala. My nature-made mandala. Did we spoke about found objects? Found objects are pieces of art. There are artists that their medium is to work with found objects, which means is that they don't paint with painting or they don't draw with pencils. They use the things that they found outside or around the house. This is too big. And their work is made out of found objects. This is found objects. Why? Because I found those leaves. I didn't buy those leaves. So technically is found objects, but in this case are natural. The characteristics of these objects is that they are not man-made, right? They are nature-made. Yes, exactly, Dante, thank you. It's nature-made, so that's why we call them found objects or nature mandala. The real mandalas, the ones that the Buddhist monks do, they are made with pigments. They are not made with found objects. They put together these pigments and they build the mandalas. And when they finish, they blew it away. It's like padwar, right? They blew it because they want to emphasize the idea of ephemeral. So here we are getting into our full circle. I don't know if I have enough of these leaves. The purple leaves, because you want repetition. Once we start with one concentric circle, let's say now I start a concentric circle of dark purple leaves, you have to make sure that you have enough to finish the circle in the same way, because you are repeating
The full circle is made with the same kind of leaf. So by following this method, you will have a beautiful mandala. So do we still have space in the frame, Dante, to keep going, or I am... it is full?
Yep, it's full.
So if I keep adding, they will not see what I'm doing, right? Will they?
No, they will not see.
Oh, okay. So maybe I put some of those in the corners, like this. Can they see that? No, no?
They can see the bottom two ones, but not the top.
Okay, so next I will document, I will take a picture with my cell phone, and I will let you see the full work in a few seconds. In the video, you will be able to see the documentation of the full work. Okay? So, see you in a few seconds. Bye! So, I hope you enjoyed it, and thanks for doing this ephemeral mandala with me. I hope you had fun learning about ephemeral, concentric circles, documenting artwork. What else did we learn? Found objects, repetition, right? Don't forget to ask your parent or guardian to share pictures of your project and tag at @ArtsForLearningMiami and use the hashtag @ArtsForLearningMiami at home on Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter. Thank you. Bye-bye.